And welcome everybody here on Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube. We're gonna be playing some Celestial Dragons to start the day off. That's right, we have Call of the Mountain, the newest expansion, is now live. We're gonna be playing some brand new decks, trying stuff out for the very first time. And we're gonna be starting here by going all Targon, all 40 cards with Targon, pairing together a bunch of Invoke cards and Celestial cards, and the Targon Allegiance card that invokes, and pairing that with the dragons. We got the Herald of the Dragons, making our dragon allies cost one less. Got a few different dragons in here, and of course, Aurelion Sol at the top end that fits everything together. So it's going to be really interesting to see how powerful this new champion is. So just kind of a reminder, this is the very first day. These are the very first games that we have. We just learned about a lot of these cards just yesterday or the day before. So these decks are not going to be perfect yet. And, you know, there's likely going to be a region that should be splashed even in a deck like this. But I don't know which region that would be. We're going to play through some games like this first and see how it goes. But, you know, those of y'all watching later on, if you feel like, you know, afterwards, whenever we get through, if there's things that you want to change or anything like that, feel free to. This is going to be a nice learning experience, learning through all of these cards. Yeah, and that's what we got. So we're going to be playing four awesome decks today. Maybe we'll play a fifth deck today, too. We'll kind of see how it's going. But we got this deck, Lulu Tarik. There we go, Lulu Tarik. Gonna be trying all the support, and then we're gonna be playing Day and Night, where we play Diana and Leona, and then Trundle Swain, trying out a Trundle deck. After that, so definitely exciting stuff here. And not only do we get new cards today, it's pretty exciting that we're gonna have new cards in just 2 months as well. Pretty exciting. Alright, so they're deciding which invoke card to grab. Ooh, that's a good card to have. Alright, so I could play Herald of the Dragons right now, but I'm going to just hold on to... Well, let's see. So I'm thinking about next turn going Behold the Infinite, and then, yeah, I'm going to do that. I'm going to go Behold, and then Lunari Priestess. So we'll invoke. Ten mana, 10/10 challenger. Attack of all your other allies. I don't know. I think it's between one of these two on the left. I don't think I'm not really into the Crescent Strike. I'm just gonna take this thing. The Immortal Fire. This card seems ridiculous. I mean, I do really like the Messenger. I'm just going to take a couple of super powerful Celestials. As you can see, the rest of my curve, I have just like cheaper things to just kind of play. What's up, Matthew? That's all good. Hope life's treating you well. Yeah, and definitely possible that I'm, you know, too greedy with grabbing two of these. That once I grabbed one super expensive one, I shouldn't have grabbed the other. That I should have just grabbed that Messenger. Definitely possible. I'm gonna go with this Moonsilver. The obliterate two enemies thing is pretty interesting too, but we can Moonsilver, get this Immortal Fire down faster. This kind of stuff seems... This does seem pretty ridiculous what we're doing here. Okay. So I can either go Priestess plus Herald of the Dragons, or I can play this Fused Firebrand. I'm just gonna play the Fused Firebrand.
Gaze into the light.
I think that's good for us getting that thing out, you know, getting that out of play. That makes it always day for them. Oh, let me change the setting over here. The camera that I forgot to change. Okay. You like the new dragon in Demacia is really good. The Immortal Fire. So this is grant me +1/+0 for each celestial card you've played this game. And so we had played a celestial card before, which was that zero mana card that made something cheaper.
Bring Nightbloom. I'll tell a story.
And that's a when I'm that's a summoned ability. I don't have to worry about my Immortal Fire dying, because if it dies, you just fully heal it instead, and then we'll have these other cards to be able to help protect it afterwards. That hush is pretty good. The good thing about this is that it already took damage. That +0/+2, even though it's a permanent buff, all that does is, you know, that's healing it, so it's not. So they couldn't hush it again. To take that damage, get that damage out of there. Let's go with the Spacey Sketcher, discard this Herald of the Dragon. And let's grab. I don't love any of these. Grab
yeah,
this thing.
That's a pretty sparkle fly.
Oh, that's awesome. Yeah, that's great, Matthew. Glad to hear. Slow. This Moon Silver is pretty good, too. We'll take the Fallen Comet that can obliterate an enemy.
And that one.
Yeah, it can obliterate a champion. Alright, now our Immortal Fire goes back to a 7-2. It hasn't died yet, so whenever it dies, oh come on, it'll just get rehealed.
Chosen of the sun, follow moon or sun, silly child, are they not one? Glorious light rains down.
Yeah, I'm gonna grab this Written in Stars. Thank you. Written in Stars can go grab Aurelion Sol for us. Reduce its cost by one, so we'll be able to play it the very next turn. I can also just wait. Let's see. So I have two extra mana. Thing is, do I even want to play this Herald of Dragons? So if I do play the Herald of Dragons, then cost one less.
Hmm. worlds, galaxies, all connected.
Don't think I play that Herald of the Dragons.
And the stars. As foretold.
All right, maybe
can
we do.
I paint you?
Yeah, we haven't even tested out this new guardian yet. These are all amazing.
They think themselves cultured.
Dude, this stuff is ridiculous that we're doing. Good boy. Yeah, so like the Living Legends, even though we have a flipped Aurelion Sol, we have a pretty full hand, and so like maybe it just get us like two or three like cheap Celestials that aren't very good, and I think instead I'm just gonna take this awesome The Great Beyond, which is super powerful, which has all these keywords and everything.
I am the bulwark against darkness.
Doesn't see any reason why I shouldn't attack with Aurelion Sol. None that I can think of, at least.
Defiance is our way.
So it has Fury, since it killed something, it grows plus one, plus one.
Light and fire are the origins of life.
We're gonna just silence this thing.
Words are lost in the roar of the winds.
Very first game, level up Aurelion Sol. Alright, so now all of our Celestials cost zero. We get random Celestials every round start. This is crazy. Alright, stun the strongest enemy. Alright, we should probably obliterate this thing. Oh, wait, it has spell shield. We can't obliterate it. Let's go with let's go with the 0 mana 14/10 challenger. Like, what? no. Wait, so that thing took damage, so it got rid of the spell shield? Oh, no. The stun thing got rid of the spell shield. Okay. Yeah, that ain't happening.
Your fate has been decided.
Oh, I got really worried there for a minute. We're going slow speed spell shield, so you don't try that again. Yeah, I got scared for just a second there. The opponent's Celestials are free too? No, this says your Celestial's cards cost zero. Okay. They surrendered.
Victory today, freedom tomorrow.
Have like a region road. We're actually unlocking stuff. We'll get those rewards later. All right, we're 1-0. My plan there, I was going to be playing the infinite. I was going to play the zero mana our other big celestial. I was going to play that, and I was going to play the infinite mind splitter on them. So I was going to do both of those. Let's mulligan all of these. Kind of want to discard Aurelion Sol to invoke a card that costs three or less, thinking that we'll probably be able to find another Aurelion Sol by the time we need to play it. I'll just get rid of this Infinite Mind Splitter. I don't know, Infinite Mind Splitter is pretty good. It is pretty good. Or it's the only mind splitter in my deck, which maybe I need to have more of. That's, you know, something that we're kind of trying out. All right, we'll get rid of it.
Spilled paint is just accidental art.
The messenger. Oh yeah, Mist Wraith deck? We definitely gotta make a Mist Wraith deck for sure. Oh, it's a bug right now, so they played a zero mana comment. So Aurelion Sol is bugged right now, gives the opponent's Celestials cost zero also.
Ours is the one true light.
Come hither, you beasts of glory!
Follow the horizon.
Possible this Herald of Dragons isn't going to be necessary in the long run. We'll see.
Clad in shining sunlight.
Yeah, I'm not worried, Gordek. You're good.
Devotion to battle.
Whoever has the greediest dragon deck wins. That's the name of the game. We're doing pretty good. I think that this one drop can probably do more than that. Let's get Fused Firebrand in play. Like, I could have gone Scryer this turn, and the next turn gone Herald of Dragons plus Fused Firebrand. That probably would have been better. I don't know, I like getting that in play. But maybe that would have been better. So far, our Celestial cards seem pretty busted. But yeah, right now with, you know, we've only played two games so far. We're playing against two other decks that are also invoking, and our deck over the first one went bigger. So far here in the second one, it looks like our deck is going larger as well. Ooh, Random Stars is good. still kind of think I want to go Mountain Scryer over Moon Dreamer. No, I guess it's just Moon Dreamer, because then I play Herald and Mountain Scryer next turn. They got the Lunari Priestesses. The whole invoke thing does slow the game down quite a bit. You know, like, now I'm sitting here and now I'm deciding between three, which is, you know, not a real easy decision all the time. And
what's that one? And that one.
And so it does slow the game down, you know, like they take a while choosing their card, I take a little while choosing my card. So it's gonna Daybreak, silence it, and then deal six. So even if they have like the protection spell, like give it +2/+2, like +0/+2. Even if they would have that, it would silence it, and then Daybreak. Alright, well, I need to play Herald of Dragons this turn so I can play Aurelion Sol next turn. So if I'm playing Herald of Dragons this turn, then I can, you know, I can either play this Involius. Well, that's gonna spell shield. GG's. Oh, whoops. 2-0. Alright. So far, so good. Aurelion Sol deck looking sweet. There you go, Matthew. Very nice. Good drafting. Yeah, Sunburst looks to be a pretty good card. Or just Sunburst. Wait. No, Daybreak is the ability. So Sunburst is the name of the card. Yeah, Sunburst looks to be a pretty good card. That was really nice being able to kill that Thresh, even though it got +2/+2 from something. Alright, looks like we got Trundle plus Aurelion Sol. Now, we're going to Mulligan. Ugh, should have kept that 5 drop. Yuck. This is what happens when you put 10 mana cards in your deck. Sometimes your opening hand just has your 10 mana cards. No, I didn't see the flavor text of the Aurelion Sol. I don't care what you write about me, you middling creature. Just make sure I'm described as handsome and magnificent and also very, very intelligent. Can you spell that? Aurelion Sol is handsome and magnificent and also very, very intelligent. And intelligent is misspelled. That's pretty good.
The skies darken with their approach.
That's pretty good. Good messenger. Wait. Alright, so I can do 3 damage to them. But I'm passing the turn so that they don't do anything after combat with all that mana, just in case. Alright, so now am I going Mountain Scryer or Fused Firebrand? This is tough. They're both awesome cards.
She was born from the mountains!
Alright. That's fine, we got our value out of the Herald of Dragons. So I'll go Mountain Scryer. Yeah, see, I bet they were trying to do that Catalyst of Aeons after I dealt 3 damage to them that other turn. I'll take this, the Immortal Fire. Thank you. And now turn 6, I can go Solari Priestess and then Lunari Priestess. And we get 2 Invokes. And then turn 7, we can play the Immortal Fire.
You small, me big.
Eh, whatever. These are pretty good. I'll take the Falling Comet.
Sunlight guided, my brethren.
Winter take you!
I guess I'm taking another Falling Comet. Obliterate enemies with 3 or less power. That's probably just not that necessary.
Believe or burn.
Go, get him! The Immortal Fire! Alright, that's kind of scary. Kinda. Alright, so if I play this other... Let's see, we're at turn 8, so we have 9 mana. So if I play the Mountain Scryer, then these also just cost 4 mana, so we can go Mountain Scryer and then 1 Falling Comet. I didn't put the 5/5 in front. Let's go with the warrior.
I know these.
I think we'll cost 3 mana now.
What will you have?
Dang, our deck's pretty good. I don't know, it's just... Like, we just always have a million cards at hand. I feel like we would get ran over by aggressive decks. Those decks aren't really around right now. So they're at 10 mana, so they can play Aurelion Sol. So for their Aurelion Sol, I would need to Sunburst and also Falling Comet. I need to do both of those. I need to Sunburst first to take down the Spell Shield, and then Falling Comet to get rid of it. Which means I can't play anything else. So let's go to combat first, see if they play it. If they play Aurelion Sol, that's what I'll do. If not... Okay, they... Then we can play other stuff. Maybe I should take this Golden Sister. I don't have room, but this would cost, what, 4 mana? We'd get a 4-3 lifesteal and a 4-3 elusive. Oh, that'd be awesome. I guess I could take this thing. 2 mana, play it, invoke again. Or I just take another Falling Comet. It's really hard to pass up Falling Comets. Hey, Big Alfredo. 4 mana obliterates. Difficult to pull that off. Or difficult to not pull the trigger on that. 3, 6, 9. So I'm at 9 cards right now. Says Overwhelm and Spell Shield.
Stars like jewels on the cloak of night.
All right, there's Aurelion Sol. I hope they don't have another Spell Shield card.
I created it.
I mean, I could just simply play my Aurelion Sol. Both gonna level up. Maybe I should just play mine. So if I try to do Sunburst and then Falling Comet and then they have another Spell Shield, that's a huge problem. Yeah, I'll just play my own. Oh gosh.
Let's rock!
I guess I have too many cards in hand. I already have 10 cards.
The constellations bow to me. The cosmos will collapse eventually.
Dude, I don't even know what I'm doing.
I
Alright, I guess I'll just play this thing and get rid of the spell shield with that. Now I can play that thing. No. Destroyer.
I created it.
No, I don't. There shouldn't be a next turn. Like, they should be very dead here with me having these large overwhelm units. Like, I can't imagine that they survive this. It's out on mobile now. Very nice. Oh, well, maybe that could be how they could survive this. That could definitely be how they could survive this. Now they have a handful of celestial cards. This is just insane, though, these games. Let's try to obliterate their Aurelion Sol. So they don't get to play their Celestials for free. They still refilled all of their mana. Yeah, we don't know what's in their hand, right? We can't say that they messed up. We don't know what's in their hand. I don't know what their hand looks like. Maybe that was the best card for them to play. It's possible.
I've become who I was always meant to be.
These things are going to be so big. These destroyers. Going to be very, very big. And they have overwhelm. I'm just basically, I'm unloading my hand of celestial cards. So these will make them even larger. Don't think they could have a harsh winds that cost 5. So we'll have 15, 16, and 17 for their powers.
Sometimes you just need a galaxy destroyed.
Oh, but I had another one.
See you next time, Runeterra.
Yeah, they're like Treasures of Deep, just way better. Big Hat Logan, brand new Twitch Prime sub. Y'all get some hype in the chat for our brand new sub. Thank you so much, Logan. Alright, everybody's trying out Aurelion Sol. Yeah, I mean, especially... Aurelion is a beast, and especially against other Aurelion Sol decks, we have time. I want to keep this Bastion to keep keep a card that can protect our Aurelion Sol. We saw how important that is. Sorry, Moondreamer. I don't know, whichever deck that you would prefer. The question is, should I play Trundle, Aurelion Sol, or Thresh, or Aurelion Sol? I don't know, whichever one you'd prefer. I'm really liking this complete Aurelion Sol deck here. I'm really liking this deck. I think I want to just play another I think I want to just play Written in Stars, draw Aurelion Sol, make it 9 drop. Yeah.
Daylight warms the heart and lights the way.
Cause this Mountain Scryer is awesome, and like having this card, like this is the reason to go all whatever our region is. I'm blanking on our region name. Targon. I just blanked on that. It's the reason to go all Targon. Oh, Living Legends is good. It's good. Look at this Moon Silver.
These are troll lands.
Try to continually reduce the cost of Aurelion Sol. All right, so I could go Herald plus Written in Stone. So we'll usually cost 10, then we'll cost 9, then we'll cost 8, then we'll cost 7. Okay, so we don't get to play it next turn. We have to wait a turn. We're gonna have turn 7 Aurelion Sol.
Ready when you are. Always ready.
Is Trundle good? Trundle's pretty good. I could Sunburst this turn and wait till next turn and do all that. Want to get rid of Trundle. We'll do that.
But I'm king.
That Trundle pretty good.
In Avarosa's name.
Okay,
come hither, you beasts of glory!
This'll take the chill off!
Alright, so next turn Aurelion Sol. That's a 12-12 with Spell Shield. I assume they won't be able to kill it. A 12-12 with Spell Shield, and that then the next turn we'll be able to have another Spell Shield to help protect it. That's the goal right now, at least. It's too early to say that this is going to be aggro versus Aurelion Sol meta. It's just too early. Like, we're all just trying Aurelion Sol stuff right now. It's way too early to call what the metagame's going to be like. People are telling you what the metagame's going to be like, or if they're telling you what the best decks are going to be, or anything like that. They're just being disingenuous. Obliterate all enemies with 3 or less power. There's a lot of those. There is a lot of those.
The cosmos will collapse eventually.
This Great Beyond seems like impossible to beat anyway. Yeah, actually, I don't even want to obliterate those because they got War Mother's Call, so I don't even want to. So yeah, let's just grab this Great Beyond.
You rang.
You rang. Yeah, they have War Mother's Call. I don't want to kill any of their units.
The constellations bow to me. Your
feet. See ya, Aurelion Sol.
I created it. I do love an audience.
GG's.
See you next time, Runeterra.
Yeah, Sheltering Hand, I'm definitely a little worried about that too. I'm worried about that this is kind of ridiculous power level. We'll see though. But yeah, I mean, you said, are there weaknesses that haven't been discovered yet? I mean, yeah, definitely. I mean, we're like a couple hours into being able to play with the cards. Like, you know, like these... All I'm doing is playing against other Aurelion Sol decks. That's all we're playing against. And so, like, we're just going bigger than all of our opponents, and we're winning these mirror matches right now. I'm just going to keep this hand. Because, yeah, this is super slow. Like, we're just playing against people that are playing 2-mana O2s and just never attacking. And so we just get to sit back and chill. Oh, I don't like that. I don't like that. That's gonna kill one of my Herald of Dragons. Yeah, so basically I was thinking here with this hand, you know, Herald of Dragons on 2, Herald of Dragons on 3, Mountain Scryer on 4, then I'm gonna have all my cards just cost a little less. I think I'm gonna play my Mountain Scryer first before I play my Behold the Infinite. I don't really know why. I mean, it's not really like it's any difference in information, because then we'd have the information to Behold the Infinite whenever we make the information for the Mountain Scryer. Well, thing is, like, just playing a whole bunch of Will of Ionia doesn't help that much because Spell Shield is super silly. It's like, they really don't want anybody to have interaction, it seems like. I'll take the Great Beyond.
Know your path, or the mountain changes.
Rude. Play the Golden Sister next turn. Let's do that. Yeah, I'm not too big on this whole Spell Shield thing either. It's probably the one thing that I'm not in love with this set. Is Spell Shield.
You are beneath me.
I mean, we have good options. Either I like either one of these, Moondreamer or the Vox. I like them both. I'll go with the Vox. It makes it harder for them to just throw creatures out here to try to level up Thresh. Hey, Kuchin. Brand new Twitch Prime sub. Thank you, Kuchin. That is amazing. Thank you. Getting the hype boats out there. That is our third sub of the day. Already. Thank you, thank you. Alright, so this thing is an 8-8 with Elusive and Fury and Spell Shield. And it'll get plus 1, plus 0 right now, so it'll be a 9-8. Next turn. That's kind of silly.
Formed in heaven's way, one night the other day.
All right, definitely just grab the other thing that can invoke again. Like, all of these games, we have so much gas, because we have all these cards that we're just throwing down here are invoking, and we're just, you know, never, like, every turn we just gain a card, because none of our cards ever use a card. Does that make sense? That's what it's like, where just none of our cards are using a card. Alright, so it looks like they're going to be playing their champion next turn, Aurelion Sol. But did they just make Aurelion Sol Ephemeral? No, because they had the Written in Stars that reduced the cost by one already. I think that was this game.
Insolence.
So that's four things dying. For Thresh. Yeah, new expansion is, I mean, looked really good so far. All we've done is played like this Aurelion Sol deck and just played played basically against other Aurelion Sol decks for the most part. Withering Wail is a good way to get rid of Spell Shield. Ooh.
Something approaches.
Do I want Living Legends? Maybe we try out this Living Legends card.
This is their end, Aurelion. We start.
Yeah, maybe we can make room for it. I do like how it refills my mana for these Bastions. That could be pretty sweet. Oblivious Islander. Okay.
Now they'll pay attention.
All right. Let's see. Let's start with this.
Bask in her radiant blessing.
So we just have infinite invokes. Well, thankfully theirs is not leveled up yet. And theirs is ephemeral. So theirs don't cost zero. Play this and invoke. I'm gonna destroy ya.
I am the traveler.
This is gonna be a lot of us doing stuff and not so much my opponent doing anything. We'll just play this and invoke. What else can we get? Nothing that good. We'll grab this challenger, I suppose.
Now they see who I truly am.
Well, good, Lionheart. Good, glad you're enjoying this list. Let's see. You can just go in for that card.
Deliberate and ruthless.
We can challenge like the elusive or something. Let's invoke some more. I don't know why I'm keeping this 2-2. I guess we don't need to keep these, do we? Alright, we'll stun a couple of things.
The mountain speaks to those who listen.
Yeah, I guess I should be getting rid of this 2-2. We still got time. Don't you worry. Don't you worry about a thing. We're gonna be winning this game. I don't know if I actually want to draw a card.
Still paint is just accidental art.
Maybe don't actually want to draw a card. So I want to empty my hand for this Living Legends. Yeah, Spell Shield stops Ruination, yes. Alright, we'll go stun. Well, let's see, now let's stun the crappy things. Even if they would have something and I need to cast this Bastion, I can, because I can cast 0 mana Living Legends burst and refill my mana. And so I still have, it's, you know, they don't have that much, but it's kind of cool that like I actually have these Bastions available if I needed them. Right now. I think if we Crescent Strike on Aurelia, we would stun one unit, I believe. I think it would still stun a unit.
Yes, this is what I see.
No, we didn't even get to see what we drew. Opponent, where are you going?
You've been wonderful, as have I.
Where are you going? Okay, so Celestial Dragons looks pretty insane. Aurelion Sol looks crazy. Man, just super powerful. Yeah, it is very slow, but we were just playing against a lot of other people trying out this stuff. But man, like, all these things replace themselves. I mean, the Herald of the Dragons doesn't, of course. But, you know, the Sketcher we get to invoke, this is invoke, the Lunari Priestess and Solari Priestess. Both these cards are pretty good at invoking. Mountain Scryer looked awesome. Just all, you know, we always invoked with this 100% of the time because all of our cards are Targon, so we always hit the Allegiance. And then having our Celestial cards cost one less was definitely important. Getting two of these in play, having those Celestial cards cost two less, that's really nice. And then, you know, our dragons did their thing of sit back and play some defense. Like, we played turn four Fused Firebrand quite a bit. The Infinite Mind Splitter looked pretty cool. Maybe we need a second one of those. Sunburst looked really good. I kind of think that maybe we need a third Sunburst. This card looked very good. You know, Moondreamer did its thing of just, you know, being a blocker and invoking. And then, yeah, we get to Aurelion Sol. And once you have Aurelion Sol, we're basically always leveled up. Every single time we played this card, round end, we leveled up. Like, we always had 10 other power in play. So that was just the easiest level up to do. We even did this on turn 7. Turn 7, we played Aurelion Sol and leveled up. So then, you know, we had this thing going on turn 7. And then, yeah, create. The whole your celestial cards cost 0 is just super silly. All, like, the amount of mana those celestial cards normally cost and how powerful they are, and just having them all cost 0, it's just ridiculous. And you can't even kill Aurelion Sol whenever you play this thing because of the spell shield staying on permanently is ridiculous. Like, how are you supposed to play a control deck with spells ever? You just can't. Like, that's not even an option. Yeah, there's no way a control deck could handle this, like, all of this invoking and card advantage and ridiculous card advantage and stuff. Well, that's how it goes. That's the Celestial Dragon. So that's kind of level one here for the new brand new format. We're going to have to, you know, we're going to try some different stuff, of course. We're going to try some more aggressive things, like our Lulu Taric deck that we're about to play up next. But yeah, this is this seems pretty bonkers. I don't know what else to say. All right, that's Celestial Dragons. Those of y'all watching on YouTube, hit that like button over there. Give the deck a try and leave those comments. Let me know how it goes for you with those games. What do you think of the deck? Anything like that? What do you want to see on stream in the coming days? As y'all know, I play at least 4 different decks every single day. So what do you want to see later on? We'll definitely try this deck out again in a couple of days too, once the metagame starts, you know, once people start trying out more and more things. You know, we didn't really play this against a variety of decks yet, and so we'll play this again probably this weekend also. All right, but that's it here for Celestial Dragons. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.